crazy bedhead right now and it needs washed in the worst possible way, and my roots need touched up terribly. And I'm supposed to be getting my hair done later today. My mom says she thinks she can do it anyway because I'm heading back to California tomorrow. So I don't know the next time after that when I'll be home to get my hair done. But I'm about to put my hair in braids because I'm trying out a wig for the first time from the brand, insert name here. I did a tutorial on their U-clip extension recently on my channel. So if you haven't seen that, I'll link it here on the screen and in the description box below for you. And I do have a discount code with insert name here. It is just KD15 and you can get a percent off of anything on their site. So feel free to use that if you want, but you don't have to, just let me know. But yeah, I'm gonna be trying out a wig from them today. It's called the Kyra wig. I've actually never tried on like a legit wig in my life. Like I've worn like a Halloween black wig before, which was kind of a vibe, like kind of cool or whatever. But yeah, we're trying on a legit like nice freaking wig today from insert name here. So I figured I would show you that. We shall see how transformative she is. And so, you know, I figured today would be a good day before I wash it later to show you how to apply a wig. Because I don't really know that well myself, but we're gonna figure it out together. What are you doing over there? You laying on my dirty clothes? He hears the people mowing our yard and he freaks out every time. They come every freaking Friday, but he still is just as alarmed. That's like also another thing about golden doodles is they're scared of their own shadow. It's like the poodle in them. You know how poodles are kind of skittish? That's him. We just got the hair braided. I just did it really quick. Well, hello. Welcome to the party, cutie. So yeah, I'm just gonna try to apply this wig now. And I just French braided my hair really quick, so I didn't do anything special. Let me try and show you. So that's what we're looking like from the back. Usually when my hair is oily, I just braid it like this and then wash it the next day. So this is works perfectly for applying this wig right now. And everyone pretty much says to just braid your hair. Hello? Everyone says to pretty much just braid your hair when you're gonna be applying a wig. This is the easiest method because you can bobby pin it up and make it lay really flat to your head. So when you apply the wig cap and then the wig, it just lays a lot smoother. So we shall find out. So first, taking her out of her package, this is what she looks like. She's 28 inches long with a straight cut at the bottom, very sleek in a good platinum blonde color. Obviously this is way blonder than my actual hair. Again, sorry if you can hear the mowers. It's kind of awkward if he's like looking at me through the window. Of this hair, oh my gosh. This is the Kyra wig and she is stunning. And then she has a darker root, so it makes it look more natural. And then it also has the inside little clips here to adjust it to your head. And this is vegan synthetic fiber, so it's not real human hair, but you can heat style it up to 320 degrees Fahrenheit. But I'm not gonna need to do that because I just wanna keep her straight and beautiful like so. And I really like the blunt cut at the bottom. So your wig will also come with a tan cap like this that you put over your hair here, and then the wig goes on top of this. So I just got my bobby pins here. And let's just pin her back. Maybe I should roll it in a circle in the back. How would that look? Maybe that's flat enough. I'm just gonna bobby pin it and hope for the best. Again, I have no freaking clue what I'm doing. I'm just hoping that this is gonna look cute. Okay, so I think I got that one down flat. I used about 4 bobby pins. So now we're just gonna roll this one. And because I have thin hair, I feel like this is working out in my favor right now. So it's laying a lot more flat versus if I had, you know, thicker hair. So now that we really look bald, let's see what she looks like from the back. I mean, it really doesn't matter, but I just want to see how bad of a job I just did. Oh my god, what is that mess? What is this? I'm so confused. Okay, well that's what she looks like in the back. Hopefully that's flat enough. I don't know. So I'm just gonna apply this beauty. Oh, thank you for stepping all over everything. That was so kind of you. Oh my god, this is really tight. How the heck is this supposed to fit around my head? What the? This is the tightest freaking thing ever. Oh my god, this is so beautiful. This is so freaking tiny. And I don't have a big head. Oh my god, I feel like the bald Six Flags guy. Oh my god. Okay, maybe we move this back a little bit. Okay, is this good? I don't know, but I know that I look crazy. Hey, and I haven't even like brushed through this at all, and look how good it still looks coming right out of the package. I am just blown away. So see how these little clips are in the inside. I'm assuming that's gonna go under the wig cap to hold it in place. Oh, and then there's these little ties that you can Velcro tighter if you need it. I feel like it would make sense to do these top two first. Let's get her centered. Okay. Now I'm gonna find the other one and put that under there. Okay, now I gotta find this back one. Damn, this baby is tight. Okay, now I'm unaware of what I'm supposed to do with that piece. Do I have this pulled back far enough? Who is she? I feel like fairy goddess. Oh my god, this would be so good for a fairy costume. Holy shit, I'm totally doing that. Can I just tuck her away? Because I don't want to cut that right now. That just seems like a big commitment. Okay, so I just kind of tucked it. Oh my god, no. Is this right? Can you please watch out? They can't see anything but your mouth. Did I do this right? You don't know? I don't know either. I can't wait for my mom to see me and be like, oh my god. You know when you get like new hair, like extensions, obviously wigs, you just like can't stop playing with your hair? Like, look how long this is. What? Insane. It's so pretty. Wow. Excuse me. I have places to be today. Oh my gosh. I cannot take myself seriously right now. But I mean, this wig is beautiful. Did you ever have like an alter ego thing with your friends? Not like you really had an alter ego, but like you would say your name was something else when it wasn't. Like if you were at the bars with your friends and like a guy would like ask what your name was, you guys said something else. Because that's what me and my friends did. And my alter ego name was Sophia. So I don't know, does that fit? For this wig, do I look like Sophia? Like my name definitely still cannot be Katie with this wig. No, that's way too basic for this wig. This is so fun to play around with. I mean, wigs are just so cool to begin with. And like I said, with every other insert name here product that I've ever tried, their bangs, their clip-in extension, like the U-clip extension I just did, and their fake pony, all good quality. And now I have nothing bad to say about the wig either. And it was really easy to apply for never really having tried on a wig before in my life. And it feels really secure to my head. This thing is not going anywhere. Like I could be out in like 30 mile per hour wind and she's staying on. I'm not kidding how secure this feels in my head. And it's not uncomfortable at all. Like I feel really comfortable and it's still like, I can obviously tell I'm wearing something, but it's a very comfortable fit. So that's a bonus. So that's what she kind of looks like underneath. But I'm not used to my hair coming this close to my eyes. So it's a little bit, you know, of an adjustment because I keep wanting to pull it back. I just feel like this wig is very customizable to anyone's head because it has the adjustable clips and then it has the little ties that you could pull tighter or looser if you need to fit your head. So it was really easy for me. I just did the two clips here and then I just pulled it and stretched it really hard to fit under the wig cap at the bottom. And I think that was a pretty good method because it was able to stretch really far and have a snug fit around my head when I did it like that. I just really love how I can transform my look in the snap of a finger with all of their products and their hot tools of any kind. It's so nice to have one place to go to that I can just get all my hair necessities. So if you're into this Kyra wig like I am, you can snag it on the insert name here website and you can use my discount code KD15. But if you see any other items on their site as well, just know you can use that code to get a percentage off as well. So it's kind of fun to play around with some different wigs, switch up your look, you know, and it's perfect for like different like Halloween costumes or like extra little parties, like special occasions, kind of stuff like that. It's fun to play around with items like this. I'm gonna be continuing to look at myself in the mirror because I'm like, who is she? We don't know her. I hope you enjoyed watching me apply a wig in the most unprofessional way possible, I feel like, but hopefully you learned something. Better say something that will change my mind. So this is what's on my under my foil.
Yes.
This light master, and then you mix it in here. California. Not the best lighting right now, and my hair looks kind of rough because I was just on a plane for 5.5 hours. My mom dropped me off earlier at like 4 or something. I had a layover in Phoenix, but I didn't have to get off the plane, which made it even worse because I felt like I was on the plane for even longer. Finally back in LA, and this is the hair update. And I dyed my eyebrows as well. I like to do that when I get my hair done because it just makes me feel better when I'm not wearing makeup. It looks like I have more of a brow on. I feel like you can get a better accurate view of what my hair looks like in the natural lighting because I'm like dealing with artificial lighting right now, and that's just not the vibe. But other than that, and laying on my hair for 5.5 hours on a plane doesn't look that bad. I'd say I probably get my hair done like every 2 months. I don't know, I could totally be wrong, but my mom does it, and her beauty shop is literally right next to my room at home. She works from home and has her own little salon beauty shop in there, so it makes it really convenient.
Hello.
I have so many packages here, and so I think I'll do a little unboxing for you. Okay, so while I'm waiting for my hair to finish kind of air drying more before I blow dry it, I figured I would do a little unboxing haul that I promised. It's been several days later. I talked to you, I think, last on Saturday when I flew into California, and it is now Thursday. And the reason why I haven't picked up the camera is because I lost someone really close to me recently. I'm not gonna say any more else about it, but I'm just going to insert a picture here. And you can read that, and now we will move on. So I'm actually gonna be flying home tomorrow, which will be Friday, and then funerals in general don't really bother me because I feel like the person isn't actually there anymore. It's just all the emotions, you know, and memories together that you have as a family, and you're all there and like thinking about it, and that's just a really tough thing. So once my hair dries, I'll show you what it actually looks like after I recently got it done, which would have been several days ago by now. Obviously I got it done when I showed you on Saturday morning before I left. My mom did it really quick. So starting with this first one that I already opened because I couldn't wait, and I've been wanting these for such a long time. I see everyone on Instagram wearing them. I don't know, I kept talking myself out of it, like it's a trend, you don't need it. 2 months went by and I was like still really wanting them, so I was like screw it, I'm buying them. So the brand is Indie Sunglasses, and she is a one woman led brand. So it's really cool to support people's dreams like this, and yeah, so it just makes me happy buying it. If you've heard of the brand Indie Sunglasses, you know it's the infamous kind of tinted sunglasses that you see all over Instagram right now, and now I'm gonna be rocking them because I freaking love them. Oh my gosh, it's like an orangey yellow tint, and it looks good with literally any outfit and just totally changes the vibe, spices it up a little bit. And I like how it's straight across and it has like no things on the inside here, so you can go like this and it doesn't, you know, get caught in your hair. That's like another thing I look for in sunglasses. I hate when they have the little thing right here because it always gets caught in my hair and tangled and I can't get it out. So I like sunglasses like this. I just overall love the shape of these and the color. It's just chef's kiss. I got some new sunglasses off of Amazon as well. They reached out to me and wanted me to review some of their sunglasses. So the brand is called Meet Sun, and you can just get them off of Amazon. I feel like there's so many hidden gems on Amazon, like I've talked about before. Same vibe, but these are more of a black kind of fade. I feel like these give off such like a badass bitch kind of energy. I believe it was 2 sunglasses for like around $20, something like that. So I mean, that's like a steal in my opinion for how cute these are. These are so cute. It's kind of like a black brown tortoise shell kind of vibe. So I feel like these are very versatile with every outfit. I feel like it's good to have multiple sunglasses because you don't know if you're feeling like a black color, a brown color, an orange color. So I always like to have multiple sunglasses on hand, and I'm just really into this style right now. Next we have this package. It literally came like a couple hours ago. Okay, so this is the brand Classy. I think that's how you say it. And I'll leave everything in the description box below for you if you see anything you like, so you can snag it for yourself as well. This pair of denim jeans, they're just like a ripped denim. And of course it is a light wash denim, my absolute favorite. So just like a classic jean. I love how it looks more tapered at the waist here, but bigger all throughout. So it's definitely gonna be looser on my legs, and I love that look. I love when denim's tight on your waist and really baggy and loose everywhere else. And then just has a classic kind of more open cut at the bottom and some rips on the knee here. I love a good open rip. I just think that gives such a cool, edgy kind of streetwear vibes. So, you know, that's my aesthetic. And then here is the actual brand, so you get a better idea of who they are. But then we have this next top. This looks so cute. It's just a white flowy crop top. Kind of has that butterfly flowy feel. Very cute minimal top for summer. And of course, white tops. Like, this looks so good with light wash denim, in my opinion. So I think this is going to be a really pretty fit together. And then we have, this is like a halter style top. And those are my favorite tops to ever exist, especially if you're wearing in warmer weather. And then the back is all wide open and ties around your back here. And then we have another top. It's this little piece of fabric that's like really satiny and smooth, and it just feels like really good quality. But I'm unsure of how to tie this right now, so I'm just going to show you a picture of what it's supposed to look like. See how it's supposed to be kind of diagonal like that? I'm just unsure of how to do that right now. You know, something a little different. Moving on to the next package. Afora lingerie. I totally forgot about this. So there's some really pretty lingerie pieces in here. So if you're looking for some cute lingerie, definitely check them out. First, we have this black kind of lace mesh dress I thought was so gorgeous. It's completely see-through, but the bottom is very flowy, and I don't know, I just think that's so fun and dainty and so pretty while being like sexier at the same time, obviously. Oh, and I think that came with a matching little G-string as well. And then we have this next set. It's kind of a florally vibe, and I love how it's very girly at the same time, even though it's black, because it has a nice mesh kind of frill on the spaghetti straps. Love her. And then comes with this really cute pair of underwear. I love the flowers on there, it's so pretty. And again, it kind of has that frilly feel on the underwear as well. And then we have a classic black lace mesh kind of feel. You can never go wrong with a black lace lingerie set, and this one is very minimal. Like, as you can tell, the whole thing is see-through, so that's gonna be a vibe. And then it comes with the matching little thong that is very pretty as well. I like how it has like the dingly little frills at the bottom there. So this will be a really cute set together. And then lastly, I got a kind of wine red color set. Again, kind of lace style, very see-through, gorgeous color, because I mean, I just love red. And then it comes with the matching underwear, and then it just has the little straps here that sit up higher on your waist and give it more of a hourglass kind of figure. So I feel like that's really flattering on. And I had to switch it up from like the black and got a pretty red color. Next, we have this big package from Lorna Jane Active. First, we have this gray sports bra, and let me tell you, she is thick and feels like such nice soft quality. And then it has the little cup inserts that you can take out if you want. And then in the back, it just says Lorna Jane Sport. And then that top is for these matching leggings, again in a size small. Has that really fun sporty vibe, and it looks like it's gonna be the perfect length for, you know, me being a little shorty. I love the white contrast stitching. I feel like it's very flattering. And then what I thought was cool with these leggings, it has these little drawstrings, which I feel like you never see on leggings. And then I got a classic white ribbed tank from them, just because I knew it was going to be really nice quality, and I love wearing minimal things like this, so I just knew I needed a pretty little white one. And I got it in a size extra small because I like my tanks to be tighter and a little bit shorter. And then I got it to match with these high-rise run shorts, and I got these in a size small. These are the shorts. It just says Lorna Jane Sport. Again, such a cute minimal sporty vibe, and I really liked the white piping that is contrasting with the black, so that's why I got this white ribbed tank to match it, because I thought it would be a really cute kind of look together that obviously you could wear like working out if you want, or like on hikes, or just like running errands. I feel like this is a cute little fit to have, and I like how the shorts are a bit longer. This is from the brand called The Comfy Society. It came in a nice little canvas bag. Love that minimalistic feel. They have such good pieces on their site, and I could not resist this little cap when I saw it. I thought this was so cute. It has like retro dad vibes, and I just can never have too many caps. I love them, and I've kind of been into wearing them more flat. Kind of gives off a more retro, again, vintage feel to your outfit. Oh my gosh, these are so cute. Oh my god, they look tiny as hell, but thank god they're stretchy. I got it in a size small. Kind of gives off a boxer feel, kind of sporty vibe, so I thought this would be really cute. And it looks cute with this hat because it's kind of in the beige neutral kind of field, you know. And then I got this little tee. It just says beach club, your relaxing seaside getaway. So I just love how they're just a very vibey kind of company. Like, I mean, how cute and relaxed is this little tee? And I wear tees all the time. Then I also have this t-shirt, which I thought would be really cute to match the hat, obviously, because it's kind of the same colors. It just says Nourish. So again, another kind of vintage tee. And I just love how that looks. It's in kind of a beigey color. And again, you know, the green writing. So really into this color combo lately. Cannot wait to wear this, and this will be really cute with the shorts as well. Kind of a more neutral theme together, and I think this would be really cute with the hat, obviously. And next we have this tiny little package, which I'm pretty sure is jewelry. So this is the brand, I believe it's called Gem & Co. I got this beautiful little necklace in here. So it comes with a really delicate chain. I love that. I love dainty jewelry, and this one has a nice shine to it. So this is what it looks like with a little pendant on the chain, just kind of a rectangular kind of shape, and then it has the beautiful cross on it. I mean, the detailing on that is stunning. Really excited to have this in my jewelry collection. And I do have a discount code with the company Gem & Co. So if you like this necklace or you want to browse anything else on their website, you can just use the code KatieCole15 and it will get you a percentage off of anything on their website. And for the last package I have for you, I think this is the brand Innovent. I could be saying this wrong. This is their little logo. So if you want to look them up on Instagram, obviously I will have everything linked below as well. So first we have this little bodysuit, which you already know I'm so into bodysuits right now. So it kind of has a mock neck style, and then open on the arms, and then the classic bodysuit kind of style at the bottom, obviously. But I got it in a size small, and the color is amber honey. And then it comes with these matching pants. I got them in a size small, and they do look, you know, a little bit smaller, but they're very stretchy. And these babies are thick, like such nice quality. Like, they feel a little bit more on the heavier side. And then it just has a nice open pant leg at the bottom, which I'm really liking the style. I'm so over like skinny pants or jeans of any kind. I really like it when it's loose and stretchy at the bottom, kind of more of that vintage 70s feel, I guess you want to call it. So I believe that was all of the items that I recently got that I had to show you. And I'm gonna go blow dry my hair because it's looking crazy, and it's pretty much almost all the way dry, but I need to blow dry it so it goes a little bit straighter, and then I can put my extensions in because I do need to take some pictures for some brands today. I've been putting it off because I just, you know, not been in that kind of headspace really to function. Like, the end product of what I'm doing never turns out good when I'm mentally just not there, you know. So I'd rather wait till the headspace is good, I'm feeling more positive, and then it comes across better on the camera. Okay, so I just blew dry my hair and threw my beautiful extensions in from the brand, insert name here. Literally transforms my hair so much. As you can tell, we have kind of the two really blonde strips in the front that they call the money pieces, and then it's a little bit darker on the root, but added definitely a lot more blonde all throughout my head, as you could tell by the foils. I feel like it's a perfect blonde summer color, and I've just really been liking the really blonde right in the front here. Even if this grows out even more, I still feel like it just is a nice vibe. My mom does such a good job. My mom's been doing my hair since, you know, ever. She doesn't even realize the talent she has because she makes everyone's hair look so good. So shout out to you, Mom. Love you to death. But I just threw on this outfit that I showed you with the bodysuit and the pants because I'm about to go shoot in this really quick. And let me tell you, this is so luxe, like nice quality, fits really good, nice and stretchy. And then I just have my little cross necklace I showed you earlier, and my rings and my other necklace that I showed you in my huge jewelry haul. Same with these little earrings right here. So yeah, this is the finalized hair update. This is what the eyebrows are looking like after I dyed them. Makes such a big difference. So I just got myself a nice little glow up from my beautiful mother. I'm just gonna end the vlog off here. I don't know what my next vlog will be because, like I said, I'm going home and going to be with family. So laid out a little bit earlier in the sun and it felt so good because I was at home in Missouri, so I hadn't been in the sun like that in quite some time, and I love my leisurely time in the sun. So anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already subscribed, go and hit that subscribe button down below. I would so appreciate it if you subscribed, and I will see you in my next video.